This lesson focuses on two major ideas like clauses and phrases. Actually, we have seen a sentence. Nammala sentence valare vishadamayittu nokkittunde. In sentence, you have a subject and predicate, and basing on this subject and predicate, we have classified those sentences to different kinds like imperative sentence, interrogative sentence, declarative sentence, exclamatory sentence, all the kinds of sentences we have seen. And again, you have you know about a simple, complex and a compound sentences, and but this simple, compound and complex sentences are classified on the basis of clauses. Etra clauses or a sentence ilunda enna adine depend cheyidirikkum endana you have the simple, compound and complex sentences. So we have to see what is a clause ennulla nammal aadi manasilakka. Appo namukku or normal sentence edukkumba namukku or subject undu, you have the predicate part. Subject is ennulla action aarano cheyyunnathu adana subject, who is the doer of the action, and the rest part from where the verb starts. Nammal simplify cheythu parayanengil where the verb starts you will have the predicate of the sentence. So Rama killed Ravana is a very fine example, and Rama is a subject and killed Ravana is a predicate, where the action takes place. From where the action starts is a predicate part of the sentence, and now these both combine together to form a sentence. Now we have to know what is a clause and what is a phrase. Ee clause nu parayumba a group of words containing a subject and a finite verb. Oru group of words aanu. It can be a sentence again, and again a group of words illa endakka venam or subject must aayittu venam, and it's a finite verb, not endana or auxiliary allengil or modal verb onnum alla avada varunathu. You need a finite verb. Eat, play, sing, all these finites, walk, fight, all these you need to have a clause there. So it is called a clause. And it is formed when a subject and predicate are combined to communicate an idea. So exactly is a sentence indeed. So endana avaru random combine cheyidittu namukku or idea communicate, or complete sense communicate cheyanengil, that is again a clause. Now we have to see a sentence inathu namukku clause um undu, phrase um undu. A sentence will always have essentially have a phrase and a clause. Ini nammal endana phrase ennulladana nammal nokkan povunnathu. A phrase is a group of words as a group of words without a subject, verb component. Appam group of words ana clause la nammalku endu unda, subject um finite verb um unda. Pakshe oru phrase edukkaanengilo avada subject um verb component illa. As a group of words without a subject verb component and is used as a single part of a speech, or a single part of speech at oru part of speech at nammal edukkum part of speech oru sentence aavuma inde edakku undavunna oru structure aanu ee phrase ennu parayunnathu. Pakshe avade oru subject um oru verb part um avade undavilla. And it can function as a noun, as an adjective and as an adverb. Idine moonu functions unda, that is you have to know it. And it has three functions, like it can be a noun, it can be adjective, and it can take the function of adverb in a sentence. Appo oru sentence inde bhagam thanniyaanu ee phrase ennu parayunnathu. So phrases nathu it can be the noun phrase, it can be the adjective phrase, and it can be the adverb phrase. So we'll see with the examples here. He lived. So he lived ennu parayumba thane he unda subject unda, lived ennullathu you have the finite verb there. So he lived, that is enough for a clause actually. So he lived in an ancient dilapidated house. House ne kurichu parayunnathana, describe cheyidittu parayana, as an ancient dilapidated nana podinju nashamaya oru veedu aanennullana. So he lived in an ancient dilapidated house in the suburbs. Appo endana aa oru area ile suburbs ile oru ancient valare palakam cherna thurumbedutha dravicha oru veettilana thamasichondirikkunnathu. So actually this is an ancient dilapidated house. Aa house ne kurichu vishadheekarichu parayana. So this is a noun phrase here. So this is a noun phrase, ancient. An ancient dilapidated house is a noun phrase here. So we can again identify the verb phrase. She was waiting for the bus. She was, you have she under was waiting. Nammal avadana predicate part mark cheyana sherikum was waiting for the bus. And she was doing something, and what she was doing, she was waiting for the bus. And this waiting for the bus is a verb phrase. Appo endana adine avadu nikkunna or action e onnum kooda onnu vishadheekarichu parayana. So that happens to be the verb phrase of the sentence. She was waiting for the bus when the accident happened. Accident sambhavikkunna samayath endarunu, she was actually waiting for the bus. Up to here, yeah, sorry. Okay, now she was waiting for the bus goes as a verb phrase. Now adjective phrase, it was a hot summer day. So now about the adjective, it is described. It was a hot summer day. Our day engineyarnu and climate was, it was summer, and again it was very hot summer. So it's a hot summer is an adjectival phrase. Appa nammal moonu karyangalana ivda nokkiyathu. One is noun phrase, second one is verb phrase, and the third one is adjective phrase. Ini namakkullathu adverb phrase aanu. It is more complicated compared to these three, noun and verb and adjective phrase. So we have adverb phrase. Sangeetha sang like a professional. Enginiyana Sangeetha paadidhu? She sang like a professional. It is an adverbial phrase of manner. Aare pole, endu pole, engane, ennulladana. So it is an adverbial phrase of manner. Engane cheydu? Valare nisaramayittalla paadu. She was singing like a professional. So it is an adverb phrase of manner. And Ashik hid the box under the table. So under the table ennu parayumba namukku krithyamayittu ariyam endana അതിൻ്റെ സ്ഥലമാണ് വിശദീകരിക്കുന്നത്, ആ ഒളിച്ചു വെച്ച സ്ഥലത്തെക്കുറിച്ച് വിശദീകരിക്കുകയാണ്. സോ ഇറ്റ്സ് ആഡ്വേർബിയൽ ഫ്രേസ് ഓഫ് പ്ലേസ്. ദിസ് ഇസ് മാനർ, ദിസ് ഇസ് പ്ലേസ്. ആൻഡ് കാർത്തിക ലെഫ്റ്റ് ദ ഓഫീസ് ആഫ്റ്റർ ഫിനിഷിംഗ് ഹർ വർക്ക്. സോ ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് എ ടൈം ആക്ച്വലി ഡിനോട്ട്സ്. സോ ആഡ്വേർബിയൽ ഫ്രേസ് ഓഫ് ടൈം. പോയത് എപ്പോഴാണ്? ജോലി കഴിഞ്ഞതിന് ശേഷം. സോ ഇറ്റ്സ് ആഡ്വേർബിയൽ ഫ്രേസ് ഓഫ് ടൈം. And Siddharth house is located near the post office. Appo endana prepositional phrase aanu. So this one goes adverb phrase, prepositional phrase, noun phrase, verb phrase, and adjective phrase. So these are the different phrases you have. Siddharth's house is located near the post office. Appo evadiyana veedu? It's near to the post office. I saw the man in the black shirt walk into the shop near the corner. Appo endana Siddharth's house is located near the post office. Near the post office ennu parayunnathana ivadathe prepositional phrase. I saw the man in the black shirt. So he is wearing in ennu parayunnathu endana? That is a preposition aanu. And near ennu parayunnathu preposition aanu. So again this goes as a prepositional phrase. I saw the man in the black shirt walk into the shop near the corner. Appo endana aa kartha shirtin ullil undirunna manushyanu nadannu poyathu? Neela shirt o vella shirt o aalalla. So the man in the black shirt walk into the shop near the corner. So this is again the prepositional phrase that is coming here. Now the clauses. A clause is a grammatical structure unit containing a subject and finite verb. So very fine definition is given here. Clause is a grammatical unit containing a subject and a finite verb. A sentence may have one or more clauses. Appo chelappo namukku chela sentences oru clause aayirikkum, adana simple sentence onnil koodathil veriyaanengil it happens to be the compound or the complex sentences. So a sentence may have one or more clauses. Parvathi is a girl who is good at dance. Parvathi is a girl, that is one clause, and she is good at dance is another clause. Rendu sentences oda combine cheyidekana, rendu clauses ne combine cheyidra sentence aanu you have here. So this sentence has two parts. Parvathi is a girl, and again Parvathi is good at dance. So this is again two clauses combined together. Note that each of these parts has a subject and predicate of its own. They are separate clauses. Idu rendinum endana? Rendu nammal ഫ്രേസ് എടുക്കുമ്പോൾ അവിടെ ഒരിക്കലും ഒരു സബ്ജക്റ്റ് ഫ്രേസ്. ഇപ്പം നമുക്ക് ഈ സെൻറ്റൻസ് എടുത്ത് നോക്കിക്കിയത് ലാസ്റ്റ് വൺ, ഐ സോ ദ മാൻ ഇൻ ദ ഷേർട്ട് വാക്ക് ഇൻ ടു ദ ഷോപ്പ്. സോ ദ മാൻ വാക്ക് ഇൻ ടു ദ ഷോപ്പ്. അവിടെ നമുക്ക് ശരിക്കും വാക്ക് ഇൻ ടു ദ ഷോപ്പ് എന്ന് പറയുമ്പോഴത്തേക്കും അവിടെ വേർബ് വരികയാണ്. സോ ദാറ്റ് പാർട്ട് നെവർ ഗോസ് ഇസ് എ പ്രിപ്പസിഷണൽ ഫ്രേസ്. സോ ഒൺലി ഹിയർ ഇൻ ദ ബ്ലാക്ക് ഷർട്ട് എന്ന് പറയുന്നതിനകത്ത് എന്താണ്? ദർ ഇസ് നോ സബ്ജക്റ്റ് ആൻഡ് ദർ ഇസ് നോ വേർബ്. അവിടെയാണ് നമ്മൾ അതിനെ പ്രിപ്പസിഷണൽ ഫ്രേസ് ആയിട്ട് മാർക്ക് ചെയ്തിരിക്കുന്നത്. സോ നൗ ബട്ട് ക്ലോസ് എടുത്തു കഴിയുകയാണെങ്കിൽ ഒരു ക്ലോസ് ഏതൊരു ക്ലോസ് എടുക്കുമ്പോഴും അവിടെ ഒരു സബ്ജക്റ്റുമുണ്ട്, അവിടെ ഒരു ഫൈനൈറ്റ് വേർബ്, ഒരു പൂർണ്ണതയുള്ളൊരു വേർബും ആ സെൻറ്റൻസിൽ കാണാനായിട്ട് സാധിക്കും. സോ ഇത് രണ്ടും ഇല്ലാത്തതിനെ നമ്മൾ ഫ്രേസ് എന്നും വിളിക്കും. എന്നാൽ ഒരു ഫൈനൈറ്റ് വേർബും ഒരു സബ്ജക്റ്റും ഉള്ളതിനെയാണ് നമ്മൾ ക്ലോസ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. ഈ ക്ലോസസിൻ്റെ കോമ്പിനേഷൻസ് ആണ് നമുക്ക് ഡിഫറെൻറ്റ് ടൈപ്സ് ഓഫ് സെൻറ്റൻസസ് ഉണ്ടാക്കുന്നത്. സോ യു ഹാവ് ദ മെയിൻ ക്ലോസ്, യു ഹാവ് ദ സബോർഡിനേറ്റ് ക്ലോസ്, ആൻഡ് ദീസ് ക്ലോസസ് കമ്പൈൻഡ് ടുഗദർ. മെയിൻ ക്ലോസും സബോർഡിനേറ്റ് ക്ലോസിൻ്റെയും കോമ്പിനേഷൻ ഉണ്ട്, മെയിൻ ക്ലോസസിൻ്റെ മാത്രം കോമ്പിനേഷൻ ഉണ്ട്, സബോർഡിനേറ്റ് ക്ലോസസിൻ്റെ മാത്രം കോമ്പിനേഷൻ ഉണ്ട്. അങ്ങനെയാണ് നമ്മൾ പലതരം സെൻറ്റൻസസ് സ്ട്രക്ചേഴ്സ് ഫ്രെയിം ചെയ്യുന്നത്. So sentence has two parts. Parvathi is a girl, and that is one clause, that is one main clause coming, and who is good at dance, again another clause coming. So notice that each of these parts has two parts, has a subject and a predicate of its own, and they are separate clauses. They are called as a separate clauses. So up to this, just see, and the second part we will go on.